Welcome to this tutorial on using Excel to do hypothesis testing on two means. We will assume in this example that the samples are randomly and independently selected from two populations of students, day students and evening students. We further assume that the populations are normally distributed and have equal variances. If we assume equal variances, then we can use what is called the Pooled Variance T test to see if there is a significant difference between the means. Here we have data from two groups of students. We have day students and evening students. In column B are 10 exam grades from the day students, and in column C we have 10 exam grades from the evening students. Let's test to see if there is evidence of a difference between the day students and the evening students using the 0.05 level of significance. To begin, we state our null and alternative hypotheses. H0, the null, is that the two means are equal, and HA, the alternative, is that the means are different or not equal. The next step after we collect the data is to analyze it. This is a t-test since the population standard deviation is unknown, so we have sigma unknown. We will assume equal variances and conduct a pooled variance t-test. To do this, let's click on the Data tab, and then go over to where it says Data Analysis. Click, and a box comes up with various analysis tools. Scroll down to the bottom here where it says t-test, to sample assuming equal variances. Select and then click OK. Now we need to fill in a couple of things. So let's start by inputting the range for variable 1. That is the day students. And so let's select B1 through B11. And now let's input the range for variable 2, and that is C1 through C11. Notice that in row 1 are the labels, in B1 is the label for the day students, and in C1 is the label for the evening students. So since we selected the cells with the labels, we need to check off here where it says labels. Now right above that it says hypothesized mean difference, and that is what we call D0. Which is usually 0 for these types of problems. So type in 0. Next is alpha. The default setting is 0.05, so let's leave that at alpha 0.05. That's all there is to it. Now, when we click OK, you will see the results. So let's click OK. And here we can see the results. There are two columns labeled day students and evening students. The mean for the day students is 72.8. And the mean for the evening students is 69.4. And now the question is there evidence of a difference in the grades between the day students and the evening students? If we calculate this by hand, we would need to compute the means, the variances, the pooled variance, and then the test statistic. Here you can see very quickly the test statistic is calculated for us. It is 0.497709. Now we can use the critical value approach or the p-value approach. Both are shown here. Let's start with the critical value approach. We set this up as a two-tailed test, so the critical values are plus and minus 2.1009. And so now we compare the test statistic. Does it fall inside the non-rejection region or outside in the rejection region? And it falls around here, which is the non-rejection region. So we cannot reject the null. Our conclusion is, do not reject the null. There is no evidence of a difference between the mean grades for the day students and for the evening students. Now we can analyze this using the p-value approach. Remember, we reject if the p-value is less than or equal to alpha. Here is the p-value for a two-tailed test. It is 0.62471. This value is already doubled. As you can see, the p-value for a one-tail test is half of that, 0.31235. So the p-value is 0.6247 for our two-tail test, and that is not less than or equal to alpha. Therefore, we do not reject the null. There is no evidence of a difference between the two groups. And that's all there is to it. It is so much easier to use Excel or some other program than to do the computations by hand. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial, and I hope you learned something.